I would really like to make my entire pupil visible, or close to visible. Is this possible? I am an Asian 43-year-old woman with very narrow eye opening. I tried to measure the opening and estimate they are only 5 to 7 millimeters. I have been teased my entire life about my eyes. It seems the narrow opening hasn't really affected my vision. I have to only wear glasses for distance when I turned 40.
Thank you for your question. You're 43 years old, you submitted 2 photos, and you're asking, is it possible to make your pupil visible or partially visible? And that you've stated that throughout your whole life you were always teased about the size of the openings of your eyes. You took the liberty of measuring that your eye opening is actually 5 to 7 millimeters, and you want to know if it's possible to lift your eyes to show more of your pupil. Well, I can certainly share with you my perspective. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. One of my areas of specialty is Asian eyelid surgery, and certainly I have experience over 20 years of practice in Manhattan and Long Island of performing ptosis surgery for Asian eyelids, and I'll explain what that is. So to begin with, the fact that your vision hasn't been negatively impacted, that essentially you wear distance glasses after turning 40, is very good, because when the eyes are drooping to the point where they really limit your vision, then you can develop a condition called amblyopia if your eyelid is not elevated before the age of 6. Now, that being said, since visual development is not likely to be an issue for you, what you have to kind of understand some terminology. When people seek eyelid enhancement or rejuvenation, we have to differentiate 2 terms. One is dermatochalasis, which is excess skin, and 2 is ptosis, which means drooping of the eyelid margin and relative to the pupil. So in your situation, most likely the eyelid margin has been probably just clearing the pupil, and as you've gotten a little bit older, it's gotten a little bit lower. So what we're dealing with most likely is a condition called congenital ptosis, basically meaning you were born with this drooping eyelid, or it could be basically a family trait, which is still basically being born with. But with congenital ptosis, where the eye muscle develops in a way which is limited, and we measure that limitation by using a combination of examinations where we measure the distance between the upper and lower eyelid, or at the lower part of the iris, and we look at the muscle function, which truly defines the degree of functionality of the muscle called the levator muscle. Levator muscle is the muscle that lifts your eyelid. Basically, when we have that information, we can make a recommendation as to what kind of surgery can be performed. Ptosis surgery can be performed in situations where the muscle function is good, from behind the eyelid, or it can be done from in front of the eyelid. It just depends on what the degree of muscle function is and the degree of ptosis is. That being said, to answer your question, first of all, it is possible to lift the eyelid, but it's very important to distinguish muscle surgery from skin surgery. There have been so many patients who have come to me who have had skin surgery by well-meaning plastic surgeons who took off skin thinking that the skin was weighing down the eyelid, not realizing that the patient really had ptosis or drooping of the eyelid related to the muscle. And of course, they still had a drooping eyelid, they just had less skin over their upper eyelid. So seek the attention of a qualified, experienced specialist, particularly one who understands ptosis and Asian eyelids, and learn about your options and figure out what makes sense to you. Ptosis surgery, in our practice, we do this under local anesthesia, with light sedation, which means you're just given a little bit of liquid Valium to relax, but we'll actually have you open your eyes during the surgery. Many times we'll actually sit you up to look at the level of the eyelid to make sure that they're matching and they look good. This is a predictor as to the likelihood of success with the surgery, and it's important to understand that since, from my experience, more than 95% of the time it can work out beautifully, but there is approximately 5% of the time where the eyelid could be too open or too low and a need for revision. That's part of the reality of this type of surgery, and it's more appropriate for you to learn that during a formal consultation with the specialist of your choice. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.